Hi everyone, in this session we will be creating our very own solar skylines using an assortment of parts available for you to start using and connecting together. So you'll be able to create some really cool little flying contraptions like so, including filling them with various characters and objects as you continue to build your scenes. So before we start building, we'll touch on navigation and working around a 3D environment. We'll also look into editing and manipulating your objects in a 3D space. And we'll also look into grouping your objects, so forming hierarchies between children and parent objects. And we'll do so with the assistance of the scene graph in the top right screen here, which essentially provides us with an overview of all the objects present in your scene. So there are three main modes of navigation within Adobe Aero. So you have orbiting around, that's essentially rotating around various elements around your scene like so. You also have pan, which is essentially, you know, moving up and down, left and right, so scrubbing across your scene on an axis. And you also have dolly, which is another term for zooming in and out. So that allows you to get up real close or zoom out from your scene like that. Now, in order to access those three modes, they are available on the toolbar on the left side. So there is orbit, there is pan, and there is dolly. You can also access them by pressing the hotkeys, one for orbit, two for pan, and three for dolly. On your right mouse button, you can also instantly access orbit by holding the right mouse button and dragging that around like so. That instantly takes you into orbit mode. Using the middle mouse wheel will let you zoom in and out of your scene, so back into dolly mode. So before we start building, it would be really good to familiarize yourself with navigating within a 3D environment. So on top of navigation, we also want to be able to select and manipulate various objects in our scene. So we can do this simply by going to selection mode, by selecting this arrow icon up here for select. Alternatively, you can press the V key to go into selection mode. And what that will allow us to do is select various objects in our scene just by simply clicking on them like so. And if we want to focus on a particular subject matter, we can do so by pressing the F key. So I've selected this house here. If I press F, it allows me to focus directly on that specific object. And this is really handy if you want to get up close and, you know, tweak and manipulate the objects on a more refined level. When you've selected an object, you'll notice that there's this 3D gizmo that appears over it like so. This allows us to manipulate the object in three different ways. So it allows us to, you know, move the object in space on three different axes. So red indicates moving along the x-axis, blue represents the z-axis, and green represents the y-axis. You can also, I'll just move it back like so. You can also rotate it on three different axes as well. And you can also scale it. So you can scale it up or down accordingly. If you want more specific control and you just want to rotate it, or if you just want to scale it without accidentally pressing one of these selections, you can come here to the toolbar on the left side and you can actually select any of these three buttons, which will take us to the move gizmo, the rotation gizmo, and the scale gizmo. Alternatively, you can select them by pressing the E key for move, the R key for rotation, and the S key for scale. So if it does get a bit confusing selecting any of these particular buttons here, you can go into a more specific setting by selecting any of these gizmos either in the toolbar or pressing E, R, or S. This can come in really handy if you just want to move it and not have to worry about rotation. A really great feature about the 3D gizmo is that you can actually snap your objects along surfaces and other objects as well. So rather than individually tweaking any of these axes, you can actually simply select the circle in the center. So there's a white circle you see at the gizmo. When you left mouse click and hold that, you can actually snap it to any surface that you want. So right now this is sort of snapped to the floor. What I'll do is I'll zoom out like so. I can select this object. I can actually snap it to any of the nearest objects nearby. So if I want this object to sit on this platform here, what I can do is I can select that, select the circle in the center. I can drag that onto this platform like so. So this saves me from having to manipulate the X, Y, and Z coordinates. I can just simply snap it to any nearby surface. It can sit on top of just about anything. So I'll pop that on there like so. I can apply this to any object. So I can select this larger house and do the exact same thing. Alright, so let's start building the foundations of our very own solar skylines. You'll notice that in the scene graph at the top right of the screen here that we have a bunch of objects for us to play with, varying from various platforms to buildings to smaller props and characters. So you're welcome to start moving them around and playing around with different configurations. You'll also notice here that we have two pre-made group examples to help you better understand how these have been assembled together. We'll also be learning how to group objects to ensure that they all stay together in one cluster. So when these start floating in the air, we want to make sure that we have all these children objects sort of parented to this main group cluster so that, you know, when we start floating this around, that all these other smaller parts will be connected to this main group. If you want to reduce the clutter in the scene, we can also toggle their visibility as well. So when you're not using them, we can also toggle their visibility by selecting the eye icon and toggling that on or off. So we can toggle that up if we're not using them. And that reduces the clutter and gives us a bit more space to work with. So we're going to start off a bit basic and select perhaps the smaller platform at this point. I want to duplicate this and move this over here so we can start building. I can either duplicate it by selecting the duplicate icon on the actions toolbar, or if I want to use my hotkeys, I can press Command D if I'm on a Mac or Control D if I'm on a PC. So I'm just going to duplicate that like so and just move that over here. So now we have a starting platform. So we want to start adding some engines to this platform to start making it, you know, float in the air. So we have this engine part here. This is the part engine small shown in the scene graph. What we're going to do is we're going to duplicate that again. We're going to place that, you know, on each of its four sides. So maybe one here. I'll duplicate that again. Another one here. I can shift and select both of these. And we're going to duplicate that again. And then I'm going to move this around. We're going to rotate this about 180 degrees. It doesn't have to be perfectly 180. And then we're going to move them to this side, like so. Going to zoom in a bit and have a look up close. So now that we have the engines in place, we might add some props and characters onto the platform. So I'm just going to select this character here and duplicate. I'm going to use the center pivot and just snap it to the surface, like so. Great. Might rotate it a little bit. There we go. So this has got a little guy that's sitting on the platform. Might add some trees. So I'll, again, duplicate some trees here and snap that onto the platform. We even have some pots as well. Plant pots. So I can pop them too. We'll also add a house. This little house might do. So I'll just duplicate that. And I will drag that across. And the snap tool is quite handy. It's great to, you know, it saves you from having to, you know, accurately align objects onto the surface. So we can just snap it on like so. I'll move the door so it's more in center, and we'll just make sure that it's fully on the platform like so. Great. So now we have a very simple, you know, floating platform. Might even add a bridge to it as well. So you'll notice there are two bridges ready for you to use. There is a metal bridge and a wood bridge. Oh, actually, that's a bit too close. We have a solar powered bridge, which is like a, you know, a power connector between platforms. And then we also have just a standard wooden bridge. So I will duplicate the wood bridge for now and just move that aside here, and I'll add it to one of its, I'll connect it to one of its sides. So you'll notice that each platform has, it's got some railing, but it's also got some openings where you can connect some bridges. So that's pretty cool. So you can go really complex with these platforms if you want to. I'll just align that like so. Great. So once we're happy with the assembly, we'll just have a good look around to see if we're happy with the configuration here. What we're going to do is we're going to group it. We're going to group this whole cluster together so that when the platform is floating in the air, we're going to make sure that all these other objects are connected to it. So we are going to select all these objects here, and then we're going to come to the actions toolbar and select this little folder icon called group selection. So we're going to click that. Now you'll notice in the scene graph, we've just created a brand new group. So we're probably going to call that, let's say, group small platform. And now you'll notice that once we lift this up, all these small objects are connected together within this one contained group. So when we look at it, when we click this little tab here next to the group icon, you'll notice that all these objects that we've just assembled together, these are acting as children objects, and they are parented to this main parent group here, which we've just made. When you're working with objects, this will come in really handy in working with really large, complex clusters. Rather than having to move each object individually, we can group them and parent them to these groups, and the groups will essentially handle all the movement for us. So this will come in especially handy when we start getting more bigger and complex with our skyline. So for example, I can even duplicate this group here, like so, and I can even, connect it across. And we can form all these really complex looking structures. We can go really vastly complex here just by simply grouping all these smaller objects together. So it's already starting to come together, and we've already got all this detail here now too. I might add a bit of variation to this second platform. I'll actually just change that to platform 2 just to help it distinguish better. So say we might remove the house, for example, and just add a bit more greenery. So I will select the tree and just duplicate and just add a bit more on here for variety, like so, and just rotate that around. Cool, so that's looking awesome. Now that we've started building the foundations of our Solar Skylines, in the next session we're going to look into interactivity, animation, and sound to bring these scenes to life.